A fun tool to use in Scratch is the pen. In this video, we're going to show you how to write a name using the pen. This is not a video on making letters jump about or how to draw objects, but it is a simple video on how to draw a name using the pen in Scratch. We're going to end up with something like this. We're going to learn how to use the pen in Scratch. So we're going to move our cat to where we're going to start, and you can see the green blocks called pen. So what we're going to start off with, we're going to put pen down. I mean, that's how we're going to start to draw. So we use the pen down, and we're going to move the cat to draw something. So we go to motion, we've got our blue blocks. We can use the X and Y. For example, when we move the cat down, you can see one of the blocks is go to X and Y, and that will move to where you move the cat to. So now if we move the cat down, you can see our X is the same, but our Y's gone down. Now our first letter is D, so we're going to move up and to the right, and then we're going to move up back to the left, and that should give us a kind of D shape. So we run that by clicking the blocks, and you can see we've got, well, it looks like a D, but it's not perfect. So we're just going to change the X and Y values so our D looks better. In this example, we're going to use a difference of about 50. So our X is going to stay the same when we draw a line down, but our Y is going to be about 100 difference. And then once we go up to the point in the D, we're going to go 50 to the right and 50 up, and 50 to the left and 50 up to go back to our start. When we run that, the D looks okay, but wait a second, we need to clear that. So the clear block is in pen. If you click that, it will clear the writing that you've done. We're just going to add the when green flag clicked. So we're going to add the clear block so it gets rid of what we've done previously. Now let's run this. You see we've still got a line going down to when we start. So what we need to do is we need to put the pen down after we go to where we want to start. So now we go to the start, then we put the pen down before we draw the D. We still got this problem. So what we need to do is we need to use the pen up block. So when you're writing, you put the pen down when you're drawing, but you don't put the pen on the paper when you're moving. So now when we run that, we've got our good D. It's quite small, so we can change the pen size. Another block, change pen size. Actually, we should use set pen size if it's the first time. So we're going to set pen size to 5. Now let's run that, see how it looks. That's a bit better. So that's a bit thicker and we can see it better. You can change the color if you like. We're just going to stick with the blue. Now the next letter is going to be R. So when we move to the next letter, we're going to put the pen up before we move, and then we're going to move to where we want to start. So we're going to start at the bottom of the R to go up. So we're going to go to the bottom of the R first, then we're going to put the pen down, and then we're going to move the cat. If you move the cat, it gives you an example of roughly where you want to go. So if you're not sure, you can use the cat to guide you. So now we're going to go across and back across and then down to make our R. So this gives us an idea of what the X and Y values are. You can see our R, again it's not perfect, but it looks okay, so we're going in the right directions. So now we want to make the R quite close to the D. We're going to write the whole of Dr. Codie, so we're going to use about 30 difference between the letters. So now we just change our X and Y's so they're nice and straight, so we can do that. So you can mess about with the different values. If it doesn't look okay, you can just change them. But it's quite handy that the X and Y block changes when you move the cat. So I would suggest using that. So here we've made a mistake. The Y should have been 50 rather than 100. And now you can see our D and R. So that's pretty much it. We've just got to think how to do each letter. So rather than making an extremely long video, we'll shorten the video by using the blocks. We've already changed the values to save time. So now we're going to draw a C. So we're going to go to the start, and then we're going to put pen down, and then we're going to draw the C. We need pen up, go to the start for the next letter, which is going to be O. Pen down to draw basically a square for the O. We do that, and we can check each letter after we've drawn it. Next letter is going to be a D. You can see the blocks are going down quite far. That's not a problem. We can just go down. So we've done a D before. The I obviously is very straightforward. Again, using pen up, go to the start, pen down, draw the letter. Here's that I. Last letter is a bit more difficult because we can't just keep moving the cat. We need to use pen up a few times to draw an E. So we're going to use pen down, draw a line, then pen up, go to where we want to go, and then pen down and draw that line. So with the E, we've got to do this a few times with the different lines. There we go. So we're going to move our cat at the end. You can see all of the blocks here. We run that, and then we've written our name, Dr. Codie. So if you want to see all the blocks all together, we can put them on one page here. You can see it's quite long, but it's not complicated. It's just using pen up to move to where you're going and pen down to do the drawing. Well, that brings us to the end of the video. Thank you for watching. If you like that, please click the like. And if you haven't already, please subscribe. Okay, see you for the next video.